Hey, welcome to another episode of FieldFox Fundamentals. I'm Dave Van Workum, and this is Jake Daly.
Today, we're going to be talking about spectrum analysis. And spectrum analysis really is just looking at the power of a signal versus frequency.
Yeah, what's really cool about the FieldFox is it can be used as both a source and an analyzer. So we're going to jump right in and get into a little experiment today where we have two FieldFoxes, one set up as a source, one as an analyzer. We're going to do a little transmit-receive test, see what's going on. So I brought my FieldFox, and it's set up as a spectrum analyzer, ready to measure whatever frequencies Jake is going to be transmitting with his FieldFox. Speaking of, Jake, where's your FieldFox?
I think I dropped my FieldFox.
You dropped your FieldFox.
I'm trying to remember where I might have dropped it. I think the last time I had it, I was radiating some tomatoes up in the garden at about 315 megahertz.
That's kind of strange and oddly specific. Well, I guess we can go up there and try to find it. I have my FieldFox ready to receive any spectra that it can find, and a directional antenna right here, so maybe we can use that, tune into 315 megahertz, and see if we can zero in on your FieldFox.
I sure hope so.
All right, let's take a look.
Okay, Jake, we made it to the garden.
I'm sure it's out here somewhere.
Yeah, I'm not seeing it. All right, let's go into SA mode, take our center and move it to
315 megahertz.
Right, 315, let's do that. All right, we got a problem. I'm only seeing the noise floor. Well, what's going on?
Yeah, let's try to drop that noise floor. Why don't you try a resolution bandwidth of 100 hertz?
Okay, I'll go to the bandwidth.
Decreasing the resolution bandwidth by 10 drops the noise floor by 10 dB.
All right, well, the noise floor dropped, but it's taking a long time to sweep. What do you suggest?
Why don't we narrow the span a little bit? Maybe try 100 megahertz?
Back, frequency span, 100 megahertz. Okay, well, now the...
And then, drop the reference level so that we can see it. This is a pretty low-level signal.
Good call. Okay, scale and amplitude, drop the reference level. All right, this is looking pretty good. Okay, let's see, not seeing. Okay, there's 315 megahertz. Let's see if I move, it gets any stronger. Okay, it's getting, there you go. It's peaking over here. Let me know when you see the your FieldFox that you dropped.
I think I see it.
Oh yeah?
There we go, it is. Right next to my tomatoes.
Ah, it totally makes sense that you were out here using your FieldFox and your tomatoes.
Let's go. Oh, that was pretty lucky that my FieldFox was radiating a signal.
And then I had a FieldFox with spectrum analyzer mode and the directional antenna ready to receive that signal.
We also learned a little something today.
Yeah, we definitely did. We learned that spectrum analyzers measure frequency versus power. And we also learned that sometimes your noise floor can get in the way of measuring smaller powered signals. We do have a few ways of lowering that noise floor. They include reducing your resolution bandwidth, reducing your span, and then changing your reference level to view those low power signals.
This was a very high level overview of spectrum analysis. If you'd like a more in-depth explanation, you can visit AppNote 150 in the description. We also have other resources such as educational videos.
Yeah, definitely check those out.
Thanks for helping me find my FieldFox, and we'll see you next episode.